It's AumSum time!
What if yellow color disappeared?
Oh no! Even my yellow teeth will disappear!
Oh, AumSum. Firstly, if yellow color disappeared, bananas will not be visible anymore. Huh? Banana lovers will be one sad lot. Secondly, if yellow color disappeared, popcorn will not be visible anymore. Movie watching experience will not be the same anymore. Thirdly, if yellow color disappeared, cheese will not be visible anymore. Pizza lovers will be in for a huge shock. Fourthly, if yellow color disappeared, corn will not be visible anymore. Cattle as well as chickens may have to change their eating habits. Fifthly, if yellow color disappeared, trendy fashion designers will be in for a rude shock. Sixthly, if yellow color disappeared, gold will not be visible anymore. Many people may not remain rich anymore. Lastly, if yellow color disappeared, sunflowers will not be visible anymore. Sunflower oil as well as seeds will be missed by many. Why do we have different eye colors?
So that we can produce different colored eye lasers.
No. Colored part of the eye is called iris. Iris contains a pigment called melanin. Melanin is of two types, pheomelanin and eumelanin. The color of our eyes is dependent on the amount and type of melanin produced. If we have more melanin with higher concentration of eumelanin, then we will have darker eye color, such as brown. However, if we have less melanin with higher concentration of pheomelanin, then we will probably have blue or green eyes. Now, according to a study, the amount and type of melanin produced in our eyes is mainly determined by two genes, OCA2 and HERC2, present on chromosome 15. Since these genes are inherited from our parents, we will probably have an eye color similar to our parents. But note that sometimes, certain mutations in the genes can produce different eye colors.
Why do we have different skin colors?
It is because of a pigment called melanin and ultraviolet radiation of the sun. Confused?
Obviously.
Alright, I'll explain. Millions of years ago, people living near equator received a lot of sunlight and ultraviolet radiation. Now, ultraviolet radiation is actually absorbed by our skin to produce vitamin D. But excess radiation can damage our skin cells. Hence, the skin of these people produced more melanin to block the excess ultraviolet radiation. Thus, over time, these people and their succeeding generations adapted to have a higher level of melanin in their skin, making their skin darker. However, people living away from equator receive less sunlight and less ultraviolet radiation. Hence, in order to absorb sufficient ultraviolet radiation and produce the essential vitamin D, these people and their following generations adapted to have a lower level of melanin, thus making their skin lighter. This is the color of a mirror.
Silver, silver, silver!
Nah, the color of an object depends on which color it reflects. If an object reflects blue, it appears blue. If it reflects all colors, it appears white. Now, a mirror reflects almost all colors, so that means its color should be white, just like snow, right? But it's not. Snow scatters light in all directions, making it appear white. But the mirror doesn't reflect light the same way. It reflects light at the same angle and direction from which it arrives. This is called specular reflection. Thus, it creates an image of whatever is in front of it. Now, mirrors best reflect light at wavelengths between 495 and 570 nanometers. The wavelengths in this range appear green to us. We can observe this when two mirrors face each other. In this case, the same image is reflected back and forth, making green color prominent. What is color blindness?
A color festival!
No, color blindness or color deficiency is a vision problem. Now, our eyes have light-sensitive cells called rods and cones.
Can I put ice cream on these cones?
Oh,
You are just unbelievable. Rods are responsible for black and white vision. They do not detect color. Whereas, cones detect color. There are three types of cones. One cone perceives red light, another perceives green, and the third perceives blue. Together, these cones help us to see the whole spectrum of colors. Now, in some cases, when one or more types of cones do not work properly, it causes color blindness. People with such deficiency have difficulty in distinguishing between certain colors or shades. For example, in red-green color blindness, the apple tree may appear like this. What if red color disappeared?
Oh no! I was thinking of coloring my hair red!
Oh, AumSum. Firstly, if red color disappeared, signals will stop showing red-colored stop sign. People will not stop at signals anymore. Secondly, if red color disappeared, rainbows will start looking incomplete. Thirdly, if red color disappeared, artists will be super disappointed as they will have to work without one of their favorite colors. Fourthly, if red color disappeared, doctors as well as nurses will be super confused as human blood will start looking transparent instead of red. Fifthly, if red color disappeared, it will be difficult to recognize roses, apples, cherries, tomatoes, as well as red chilies. Sixthly, if red color disappeared, lipstick industry might suffer as red color is one of the best-selling colors. Lastly, if red color disappeared, people whose favorite color is red will be mightily disappointed. What if black color disappeared?
Oh no! Now how will I show off my majestic black hair?
Oh, AumSum. Firstly, if black color disappeared, people who like to dress in black will be severely disappointed. Secondly, if black color disappeared, people having black colored hair may be left dumbfounded as their hair will not be visible anymore. Thirdly, if black color disappeared, people owning expensive black cars will not be able to show off anymore. Fourthly, if black color disappeared, people suffering from ophidiophobia, as in fear of snakes, as well as arachnophobia, as in fear of spiders, may get terrified as black snakes and spiders will not be visible anymore. Fifthly, if black color disappeared, dark black rain clouds will not be visible anymore. Predicting rainfall may get more difficult. Lastly, if black color disappeared, coal will not be visible anymore. Coal mines may have to shut down. What if green color disappeared?
Oh no! I just painted my hair green!
Oh, AumSum. Firstly, if green color disappeared, green leaves will become invisible. Green cover of cities will suddenly vanish. Secondly, if green color disappeared, forests will suddenly start looking extremely different. Thirdly, if green color disappeared, plants may not be able to perform photosynthesis anymore. World may face a severe food crisis. Fourthly, if green color disappeared, health-conscious people who eat salads containing green leafy vegetables will be extremely disappointed. Fifthly, if green color disappeared, grass will also become invisible. Golf courses will not appear that attractive anymore. Sixthly, if green color disappeared, tennis balls will not be visible anymore. Different colored balls may have to be used. Lastly, if green color disappeared, gardens will suddenly start looking rather incomplete. People may stop visiting them. What if blue color disappeared?
Oh no, I just bought blue lenses for my eyes.
Oh, AumSum. Firstly, blue jeans are extremely popular worldwide. If blue color disappeared, people will have to look for other dressing alternatives. Secondly, if blue color disappeared, the magnificent blue sky will not be visible anymore.
Huh?
Professional photographers will surely miss it.
Mm.
Thirdly, if blue color disappeared, beaches will also lose their charm.
Huh?
Tourism may suffer.
Mm.
Fourthly, if blue color disappeared, artists who love to use different shades of blue color in their paintings may give up painting altogether.
Mm.
Fifthly, if blue color disappeared,
rainbows
will suddenly start looking rather incomplete.
Mm.
Sixthly, if blue color disappeared, tests written using blue-colored ink will also disappear.
Huh?
Teachers will have a tough time evaluating them.
Mm.
Lastly, if blue color disappeared,
lavish
swimming pools may not be visible anymore. Five-star hotels may lose their charm. Topic: pathogens. Why do we get fever?
So that we can take a holiday from work.
Nah. Huh? Fever is a protective response of our body to fight against pathogens such as bacteria, viruses, and fungi. These pathogens cause diseases. Hence, when pathogens enter our body, the immune cells, such as white blood cells, produce chemicals called pyrogens, which are released into the bloodstream.
Oh, I thought like movies, they are released in theaters.
Please, pay attention.
Hmm.
Hypothalamus, which is a small part of our brain, regulates our body temperature.
Hmm.
However, when these pyrogens reach the hypothalamus, it starts to raise our body temperature, thus producing fever.
Hmm.
Now, one of the reasons for producing this fever is that many pathogens cannot survive at high temperatures. Thus, they die and we remain safe. Topic: pimples.
Huh?
Oh.
Why do we get pimples?
Because they don't want me to look handsome.
No. Pimples are caused due to the activity of sebaceous gland present in our skin.
Hmm.
This gland produces an oily substance called sebum. Sebum comes up to the skin surface through a pore and moisturizes our hair and skin.
Oh, like a moisturizer?
Absolutely.
Oh.
However, sometimes the pore gets blocked due to dead skin cells. Due to this blockage, the sebum gets accumulated, creating a bump. As sebum is a very good source of nutrients for the bacteria in our skin, they start to grow in that area, leading to an infection. Our immune system responds to this infection by sending blood and immune cells. Blood makes the area red, whereas the immune cells kill the bacteria, resulting in inflammation and formation of a pimple. Topic: snoring. Why do we snore?
I don't snore. I sing.
Ho ho, ho ho.
All right. Now let me explain.
Hmm.
Snoring is a noisy, rattling sound occurring during sleep.
Oh, really? I thought snoring is a pleasing piano sound.
Please listen.
Huh?
Snoring is basically caused due to obstruction of air in our respiratory tract during breathing. When we breathe, we take in air through nose or mouth, which then passes down the throat into the lungs. Normally, when we aren't asleep, our mouth parts like soft palate and uvula keep this tract wide open, allowing air to pass easily.
Hmm.
However, excess growth of soft palate and uvula in some people causes snoring.
Oh.
So when these people sleep, these parts fall on the back of their throat, creating an obstruction. Hence, when they inhale, the air hits these parts, making them vibrate, which we hear as snoring. Topic: dandruff.
Oh.
Why do we get dandruff?
Tearing of pages.
Nah.
Huh?
Dandruff is a condition in which our scalp sheds skin cells in the form of white flakes. A yeast called Malassezia globosa is one of the mostly accepted reasons for causing dandruff.
Wow. What a classy name it has.
Hmm.
Indeed, Malassezia globosa is naturally present on our scalp.
Huh?
It feeds on sebum and releases oleic acid. Now, some people are sensitive to this oleic acid. When it penetrates the upper layers of their skin, it causes inflammation. Hence, in response to this inflammation, their skin sheds a large number of skin cells at a higher rate. These cells then join together, forming white flakes, thus causing dandruff.